Hello, I'm Kent Weakley, and I'm going to show you how this photo is made. Photographing the full moon can be a little bit tricky. It's a very bright object in a dark sky, but there are some tricks to doing it. Let's step outside and I'm going to show you how to set up the camera.
I'm going to show you a little bit about the equipment that I'm going to use before we get started and before it gets dark. I'm shooting with the Nikon D800E and the 400 to 200 millimeter f4 lens. Now, don't be intimidated by the size of this lens. Essentially, the big advantage of this lens is the amount of light that it lets in, not necessarily magnification. A lot of people think that when they see a big lens like this that I'm able to zoom in and, like for instance, when we're shooting the moon like this, that we'll be able to see little rocks on the moon and that. That's not the case. As a matter of fact, this lens, the final image will be very similar to a smaller sensor-sized camera with a 200 millimeter kit lens. The big advantage of this particular lens is that it lets in a lot more light, and that will allow me to shoot at faster shutter speeds. Now, for this particular shoot, that's not going to be a big factor. What we're going to be doing will work great with basically any lens, and the settings I'm going to show you will work with an average kit lens, and you'll be set. Now, one of the things you do need to know is if you have a lens that has vibration reduction on it, like this one does, and you're mounted on a tripod like I am right now, you're going to want to turn that off. On this particular lens, the VR setting is right here on the side. That needs to be turned off. The camera, or the lens rather, will be looking for vibration. So if you're hand holding this lens and you're shooting, vibration reduction is a must. But when it's locked down, there's no vibration. However, the vibration reduction sensor in there is looking for motion and it's trying to counter that. So sometimes it'll actually add motion to an image. So you really don't want that. So when you're locked down, turn off the VR feature on your lens. The moon is the second brightest object in our sky, only second to the sun. It's super bright, and you're going to see when we use a very calculated exposure to expose for the full moon what will happen. And because the moon's so bright, we won't have any trouble autofocusing on it with our camera, with our lens. Now, if this were a night shoot with stars or things of that nature, those are a little bit more difficult to focus on. And right now, while there's still a little bit of light outside, this would be a great opportunity to focus our lens. And the way you would do that would be to go ahead and take an object that's super far away, at least a couple hundred yards, a tree or a light pole or something like that. Go ahead and push halfway on your shutter release, get your autofocus, make sure you're focused, make sure it's sharp. You might even take an image, pull it up on your LCD, zoom into it, make sure it's sharp. Then, careful not to move the focus ring, you essentially take your lens and turn it from automatic to manual mode. At that point, the lens is no longer going to try to autofocus. The other thing you can do to make sure that that ring does not move is to take a little piece of gaffer's tape and just lay it across the lens so that that ring doesn't rotate accidentally in the dark while you're shooting. But again, for tonight, what we're going to be doing, autofocus will work great. It's the camera and everything will be able to see the moon perfectly, and we'll get a good lockdown focus on it as we go. Okay, so here's the moon, and I'm going to set up a typical problem that occurs initially. I'm going to set this up in aperture priority, which is one of the automatic modes. I'm going to bring my focus up here on the moon, bring it in here so we've got focus, and I'm going to go ahead and make the shot. Now, what happens is we have this moon that is completely blown out, and that's not going to work. So instead of using aperture priority or any kind of automatic exposure setting, we're going to use a fixed exposure. This is old school. This goes back to the Sony 16. This is called the Mooney 11. And the way this works is we're going to set an aperture. Now, here's another thing, too, before I get into that. The ISO is, right now I've got it cranked way up to like 4,000. Well, I don't need it to be cranked up that high because we don't need to soak up that much light. Remember, the moon is super bright when it's full. So instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the aperture, I'm going to go to full manual mode, and I'm going to take the aperture, or I'm sorry, the ISO way down because I'm going to make a nice quality resolution. I'm going to go down to 200. I'm going to bring the focus back up here, make sure we get focus on the moon. Now, here's the Mooney 11. This is the way it works. we're going to go to aperture. The aperture setting is going to be F11. And we match the ISO to the shutter speed. So in this case, the ISO is 200. Now I'm going to take the shutter speed and bring it up to 200. Now you're initially thinking, wait a minute, this image looks dark. But let's go ahead and take a look and see what that looks like. So here's the image. Let's zoom in and look at this. And we can see we're actually seeing the craters and the shapes on the moon the way they appear without being blown out. Now, again, when you set the camera in any kind of automatic mode, the tendency is for the camera to way overexpose the moon, so you just get this white blob. This is always fascinating. Look at the craters right on the edge of the moon there. I love that. You can actually see the detail going right down the edge. This plays right into the effect of what happens when you see edge lighting or backlighting. It really helps you define the space around it so you can see the edges. So let me demonstrate the Moon 11 another with a different setting here. Just to reinforce how this is working, I'm going to recompose the moon here. I'm going to set focus on it. Again, you can see how bright the moon is and how easy it is to focus on. So now, our ISO is at 200. Let's bring the ISO to, let's bring it to 400. Now, if we shot with these existing settings, we're going to be overexposed again. The moon's going to be bright. So now all I got to do is remember, Mooney 11, the aperture F11 stays the same. So now all I got to do is bring the shutter speed up to 1/400th of a second and go ahead and make the image. And there it is. And there we have a well-exposed moon at an aperture of F11, 400 ISO, and 1/400th of a second. And again, you can see the details of these craters on the side. They're just beautiful. I love exploring that. That's how you shoot the full moon using the exposure setting, also known as the Mooney 11, which means you have your aperture set to F11 and you match your ISO to your shutter speed. It's that simple.
Now back inside, let's take a look at these images in Lightroom, and I'm going to show you how I finish them up and make them look great. All right, I'm going to grab an image here, and I'm going to go over to Develop module. I'm going to crop this. Now, this particular camera has a pretty high resolution, which allows me to crop this and still have quite a bit of detail. This is what helps make it look nice and large and helps us see all those details in the moon. So I'm going to crop it down pretty small like this. Now the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to my whites. That's the brightest part in the photo. And we don't have to worry about the background because we know there are no whites over there. We're just going to slide this over and I'm looking at the histogram up in the top right corner. I'm going to make sure that that doesn't go all the way to the side. I'm going to make it pretty bright. Okay, that's looking good. I'm also going to take the shadows and I'm going to play with those a bit. I don't think I need to do anything. Here's a good opportunity to look at contrast. You can see what would happen to the image if I add some contrast to it. I kind of like that. I'm also going to add a little bit of clarity. Right up here along the edge of the moon, you can see there's a little blue band that's occurring. That's called chromatic aberration. And we can remove that in Lightroom. Just simply go over to the lens correction and click on remove chromatic aberration. And if you need to adjust it, you can adjust it more, but that took care of what we needed right here. I'm going to go over to the detail and I'm going to add some sharpening to this. Now this has got a little bit of noise in it, so I'm going to add some noise reduction as well. The full moon, when it rises, has a lot more color in it. And that's because of the atmospheric conditions that the light from the sun is going across the Earth and lighting the moon with. And typically that will warm it up and it might even add a little bit of magenta to it. I don't really care for the magenta so much. And the warmth, I'm going to dial that back a little bit. I kind of like how that appears. When you're out photographing the full moon, use the Mooney 11 exposure settings in your camera. Take your images into Lightroom and use the adjustments that I showed you here, and you'll have some beautiful images of the full moon. I hope you've enjoyed this episode of How This Photo Was Made. Be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and share this with friends. I really want to share the joy of photography with everyone. Thanks, and take care.